in the future.
I mean, more and more.
Jeanette, we'll have to interrupt you there. Let's take you live to Southwark Crown Court, where the jury has returned its verdict in the Gary Glitter trial. Ender Brady is there. Ender.
Well, breaking news here at Southwark Crown Court. I can tell you that Gary Glitter has been found guilty of a string of historical child sex charges dating all the way back to 1975. He is sitting in the dock inside Court 1. I'm told he has been shaking his head from side to side and muttering to himself as the foreman of the jury has delivered damning verdicts, really, against Gary Glitter. Guilty on one charge of attempted rape, guilty of five indecent assaults, guilty of sexual intercourse with a girl under the age of 13. He's sitting in court and he has been listening as the jury have returned guilty verdict after guilty verdict. Now, these charges relate to a time period 1975 to 1980. Glitter is being prosecuted under his real name of Paul Francis Gadd. He is 70 years old now. This trial has been going on for 2.5 weeks. He was the very first person arrested as part of Operation Yewtree, the post-Jimmy Savile investigation launched in October 2012 by the Metropolitan Police. Three female complainants have all come to court and given very powerful testimony about the abuse Glitter inflicted on them in the 1970s. Various locations, from hotels in Leicester, Birmingham, to a nightclub in Watford, to a private property in the south of England. The very first charge, one of attempted rape, Easter 1975. The victim, who obviously can't be identified for legal reasons, she's a woman in her 40s. She came to court and she said that she was staying at a property in the south of England, and she told the jury that Gary Glitter had tried to rape her. And she said that the very next day was Easter Sunday. He behaved as if nothing had happened, and she told the jury that he gave her an Easter egg. She said she remembered it very, very clearly indeed. Now, Gadd's defence throughout all of this trial has been that he claimed he had never met any of these women. He said quite simply none of the abuse had happened. On cross-examination by John Price QC, the prosecuting counsel, Glitter broke down in tears, and he said that various different allegations, his conviction in 1997 for having 4,000 child porn images on his computer, he said that had destroyed his life. He wept in court, he sobbed, he wailed. He even called for the end of internet pornography of children, as he termed it. But quite clearly, the jury has not believed a word he has said here over the past 2.5 weeks. These are indeed damning verdicts against Gary Glitter, and that one charge of having sexual intercourse with a child under the age of 13, that carries a potential life sentence. He's almost 71 years of age now, so Gary Glitter could die in prison.
And Ender, Gary Glitter had previous convictions for having child pornography on his computer.
Yes, he had. So that was 1997. He took a computer to PC World in Bristol, and an engineer working there found very disturbing images. 4,000 in total the police recovered off that computer after they received the tip-off from that PC World employee. There was a court case, and he faced 54 charges. Now, he went to prison. He was sentenced to 4 months for possession of indecent images. He served 2 months. Upon being freed from prison, he spoke to reporters outside the jail, and he said that he wanted to get on with his life, and he said he was sorry for what he had done. But for Gary Glitter, getting on with his life meant going abroad and abusing children. We can now, of course, tell you that he was convicted in Vietnam in 2005 of very serious abuse offences against young children there. He served nearly 3 years in prison, of course, in Vietnam. There had been allegations against him in Cambodia as well the year before. He was deported from that country. He went to Vietnam and he abused young children there. The jury were not told about anything he had done in the Far East, of course, but it was he who acknowledged what he had done in 1997 with those abuse images on his computer. His version of events was that he was a man who was under immense pressure financially, emotionally, with relationship difficulties, and creatively, with people wanting more new material from him. He said he was drinking, he said he was taking drugs, he even told the court that he had been abused as a child by himself, and that basically he was trying to understand his own feelings, and that was why he had downloaded some 4,000 images onto his computer. He wept openly in court when he was talking about that conviction, and he said that it had destroyed his life, and he said that he was very, very sorry, but he had accepted his responsibility back then. The jury bought none of it, looking at those verdicts coming in, very serious verdicts against Gary Glitter.
It's 4 o'clock, you're watching Sky News. Breaking news in the past few minutes, the disgraced former pop star and convicted paedophile Gary Glitter has been found guilty of a string of new child sex offences. Enda Brady is at Southwark Crown Court for us. Enda, take us through what he's been found guilty of.
Well, drama inside Court 1 in the past few moments. The jury have now come back in with verdicts on all of those charges. There were 9 charges in total against Gary Glitter. He is being tried under his real name of Paul Francis Gadd. He has been sitting in the dock, shaking his head from side to side and muttering to himself as guilty verdict after guilty verdict has been returned here at Southwark Crown Court. Guilty of the attempted rape of a child under the age of 10. Guilty of 5 indecent assaults, guilty of sex with a child under the age of 13. That one charge alone potentially carries a sentence of life imprisoned. He is almost 71 years of age now, Paul Gadd, so potentially he could die behind bars. His mood right now, very, very different to his demeanour this morning when we saw him skip into court. I watched as he entered the dock this morning at about 10 a.m. He gave a very flamboyant bow to the lip-speaking interpreters sitting there to help him. He is profoundly deaf. He has been following this trial and all of the evidence and all of the proceedings with the help of lip-speaking interpreters, two ladies who sit either side of him, and they repeat word for word what each witness, what the judge has been saying, Mr. Justice McCreth, throughout this trial. And he gave them a very flamboyant bow as he entered the dock this morning. I'm told he actually said on his way into court, let's get this show on the road. Well, for Gary Glitter, the show is now very much at an end. Guilty verdict after guilty verdict has come back in here in the past few moments.
And throughout this two-week trial, we heard damning evidence from his victims detailing how he manipulated them, one of them in front of their parents.
Yes, there were very, very disturbing aspects to all of these charges, really. From the very first one, which was the attempted rape he was found guilty of, that was Easter 1975, all the way through indecent assault after indecent assault. One of the victims, they had been to a Gary Glitter concert. Her mother was present and she was asked to leave, and she did. And she ended up with the child being left alone with Gary Glitter backstage in a dressing room. This was in Bailey's in Watford. And the child was indecently assaulted on two occasions by Gary Glitter, Paul Gadd, as he is being prosecuted under in this trial. Very, very serious allegations. Now, of course, he was the first person arrested as part of Operation Yewtree in October of 2012. In the post-Jimmy Savile investigation, which was launched that week in October by the Metropolitan Police, the very first name they went looking for to speak to was Paul Gadd. They arrested him. He gave no comment throughout any of his police interviews. He denied everything that was put to him, basically. In court, under cross-examination, he broke down in tears. He wept openly in front of the jury, saying that allegations had destroyed his life. He had never met any of these women. And he said this would not be the first time that people had made false allegations against him in return for money. I've been looking at the background to all of this case, to Gary Glitter's life and career and his offending, and we can take a look at that now.
Mirror, mirror, framed in gold, in your depths a story hold of a rock star who became a monster!
Chillingly prophetic, this was Paul Gadd at the peak of his fame.
Things ain't always what they seem.
I must have lived a thousand times.
But behind the wig, the makeup and the Gary Glitter stage persona, there lurked a terrible secret. He was a child sex abuser, assaulting underage girls in his dressing room.
Gadd is a very dangerous man. He's got a predilection for young girls. His offending behaviour goes back many, many years. And there will be many, many more above and beyond those people who have come forward and given evidence in this trial. Every single place where Glitter has been as an adult, I am sure he's offended.
Gadd's sexual interest in children only came to light in 1997 when he took his computer to be fixed at PC World in Bristol.
4,000 images of men having sex with children were discovered. He pleaded guilty and was jailed for 4 months in 1999. 6 years before that arrest, he appeared on This Is Your Life. Watch closely as a reference by Tessa Dahl to schoolgirls prompted Gad to make a rapid gesture, urging her to be silent.
Gary actually came to live in my house when he was between jobs.
But I was absolutely broke.
My sister Lucy turned it into quite a successful venture because she used to pack the train full of her adolescent school friends in school uniform and they'd Skype school. And she'd bring them up to the house and charge them £5 a head to come and gaze at glitter.
This was him leaving prison in 2000.
I want to put it all behind me. And live my life.
But for Glitter, that meant fleeing abroad and abusing children. Kicked out of Cambodia, he flew to Vietnam, where he again molested young girls.
What's your reaction to that?
Unbelievable.
Are you sorry for what you've done?
No, I'm not. I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
I am innocent.
It's a conspiracy.
Right in the front, guys. Right in the front, Jim.
You know who.
His Vietnamese lawyer spared him from child rape charges, punishable by firing squad, by paying his victims £1,000.
If I met him, I would beat him. I'm very sad because my daughter is too young and I'm ashamed of what she did. I almost died after what happened.
Thank you. Is there anything you would want to say?
Gad spent almost 3 years in jail in Vietnam and was once more deported, this time back to Britain. In 2012, he became the first person to be arrested by Operation Yewtree detectives, the abuse investigation sparked by the Jimmy Savile revelations.
There's been criticism off the back of Savile and the creation of Operation Yewtree that it hasn't been effective, it's been a witch hunt, it's gone after the wrong type of people. Well, those people need to shut up, because the reality is that we now have Max Clifford in jail, we have Rolf Harris in jail, we have a number of other people who have been through prosecutions and other ones that are pending. And we are in a position now where those people who had the highest profile, those people who were allowed to get away with offending behaviour for a very long time, have been brought to justice.
Paul Gad now faces another prison sentence, the latest celebrity sex offender caught as part of Operation Yewtree. Ender Brady, Sky News.
Let's go back to Ender at Southern Crown Court. As you said, he now faces a prison sentence. When will we be hear what that sentence is?
Just a little bit more information. Just hearing from Mr Justice McCreth inside Court 1. He intends to sentence Paul Gad, also known as Gary Glitter, on February 27th. He potentially faces the rest of his life in prison. And I'm just hearing that bail has now been withdrawn. So every evening throughout the trial, he has been free to come and go. He will not be leaving court this evening.
Ender, thank you.
Correspondent Sarah Campbell has the story.
Glitter's image now couldn't be further from the glam rock star of the 1970s.
Do you want to touch me?
His back catalogue is difficult to watch and listen to, knowing what he was doing in private to girls as young as 8 years old. Now age 70, Glitter, known in court by his real name Paul Gad, has heard those girls, now middle-aged women, describe what he did. When the jury returned their verdicts one by one, he shook his head, raised his eyebrows and mouthed no, seemingly unable to believe what he was hearing.
Paul Gad has shown himself to be a sexual predator who took advantage of the star status afforded to him by targeting young girls who trusted him and were in awe of his fame.
The attacks took place at the height of his success, and one of his victims said in court he was famous. Who would believe her?
A second woman took the jury back to Leicester in the 1970s. There was a venue called Bailey's. She and her mother watched Gary Glitter perform here, met him backstage, and he invited them to his hotel suite. She, like the other women involved in this case, sobbed throughout much of her evidence, describing how she found herself alone here with Glitter, drinking champagne and having sexual intercourse with the man whose posters were all over her bedroom walls. He was in his 30s, she was 12.
Glitter remained a household name throughout the late 70s and 80s. It wasn't until 1997 that his dark side emerged, when a computer he'd taken for repair was found to contain images of child abuse. After serving 2 months in prison, he appeared emotional and contrite.
I've served my time. I want to put it all behind me.
But in 2006, he was jailed again, this time in Vietnam, for molesting two young girls.
I am innocent. It's a conspiracy.
Speaking for the first time, one of the girls, who was 11 when she was attacked, says she's still traumatized by what he did to her.
He then grabbed me and dragged me into the bedroom. He did it to me. I didn't know anything at the time. He looked like a father figure. I didn't expect that he would do these things, these terrible things. Please do something so he doesn't commit these crimes again.
The one and only Gary Glitter in person, Gary.
Two men, connected by their celebrity and, as we now know, a desire to abuse children. It wasn't long after Jimmy Savile's dramatic fall from grace that Glitter became the first high-profile arrest by officers investigating historical sexual abuse. Tonight, he's in custody and the police are looking into further allegations against him. Glitter's final years may well be spent behind bars. Sarah Campbell, BBC News, Southwark Crown Court.
Going to leave that report there, take you live to Southwark Crown Court, hearing now from Detective Chief Inspector Mike Orchard from Operation Yewtree after Gary Glitter was found guilty of a string of sex offences.
Who trusted him and were in awe of his fame. His lack of remorse and defence that the victims were lying makes his crimes all the more indefensible. I am pleased that the jury were able to see through this. I would like to commend the bravery of the victims for coming forward. The courage and strength required in order to report allegations of this nature cannot be underestimated. And without their testimonials, we would have no case to bring to court. Paul Gadd was the first individual arrested under Operation Yewtree. This goes to highlight the complexities involved in dealing with offences of this nature and our determination to pursue all lines of inquiry and, wherever possible, present these cases before the courts. Thank you.
Brief statement there from Detective Chief Inspector Mike Orchard from Operation Yewtree, talking there about the lack of remorse that Gary Glitter showed. The 70-year-old pop star, whose real name is Paul Gadd, said that lack of remorse made his crimes even worse. He commended the bravery of the victims for coming forward, thanked them for their participation in this trial. Gary Glitter found guilty within the past hour of six charges of sex acts against children dating back to 1975 to 1980.
This is Sky News with Andrew Wilson.
Very good evening to you. Gary Glitter's tonight been found guilty of a string of historical sex offences against young girls. The 70-year-old was convicted of one count of attempted rape, four indecent assaults, and having sex with a girl under the age of 13. As he was taken down to the police cells, he blew a kiss to the courtroom after the judge warned he'll be kept behind bars until he's sentenced later this month. Well, within the last few minutes, police have just released this image of him, believed to show him leaving court. And we'll be live at Southwark Crown Court in just a moment. But first, Sky's Ender Brady has tonight's main report.
This was Gary Glitter arriving at Southwark Crown Court a few hours before the jury returned damning guilty verdicts against him. He was prosecuted under his real name.
Mirror, mirror framed in gold, in your depths a story hold of a rock star who became a monster!
Chillingly prophetic, this was Paul Gadd at the peak of his fame.
Things ain't always what they seem.
I must have lived a thousand times.
But behind the wig, the makeup, and the Gary Glitter stage persona, there lurked a terrible secret. He was a child sex abuser, assaulting underage girls in his dressing room.
Gadd is a very dangerous man. He's got a predilection for young girls. His offending behaviour goes back many, many years. And there will be many, many more above and beyond those people who have come forward and given evidence in this trial. Every single place where Glitter has been as an adult, I am sure he's offended.
Gad's sexual interest in children only came to light in 1997 when he took his computer to be fixed at PC World in Bristol. 4,000 images of men having sex with children were discovered. He pleaded guilty and was jailed for 4 months in 1999. 6 years before that arrest, he appeared on This Is Your Life. Watched closely as a reference by Tessa Dahl to schoolgirls prompted Gad to make a rapid gesture, urging her to be silent.
Gary actually came to live in my house when he was between jobs.
But I was absolutely broke.
My sister Lucy turned it into quite a successful venture because she used to pack the train full of her adolescent school friends in school uniform and they'd Skype school and she'd bring them up to the house and charge them £5 a head to come and gaze at Glitter.
In slow motion, it's quite clear Glitter did not want that story being told on national television. This was him leaving prison in 2000.
I want to put it all behind me. And live my life.
But for Glitter, that meant fleeing abroad and abusing children. Kicked out of Cambodia, he flew to Vietnam, where he again molested young girls.
What's your reaction to that?
Unbelievable.
Are you sorry for what you've done?
No, I'm not. I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
You've been found guilty.
I am innocent. It's a conspiracy.
Right in the front, guys. Right in the front, Jim.
You know who.
His Vietnamese lawyer spared him from child rape charges, punishable by firing squad, by paying his victims £1,000.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Is there anything you would want to say?
Gad spent almost 3 years in jail in Vietnam and was once more deported, this time back to Britain. In 2012, he became the first person to be arrested by Operation Yewtree detectives, the abuse investigation sparked by the Jimmy Savile revelations. Outside court, detectives who investigated Gad gave this reaction.
Paul Gad has shown himself to be a sexual predator who took advantage of the star status afforded to him by targeting young girls who trusted him and were in awe of his fame. His lack of remorse in defence that the victims were lying makes his crimes all the more indefensible. I am pleased that the jury were able to see through this.
Gad was remanded in custody. He now faces a potential life sentence, the latest celebrity sex offender caught as part of Operation Yewtree. Enda Brady, Sky News, at Southwark Crown Court.
Enda's live at Southwark Crown Court for us now. Enda, the end of a long, ugly trial and no bail posted ahead of sentencing.
No, Gary Glitter will tonight spend his first night in prison. He will stay there until sentencing on February 27th. A prison van left Southwark Crown Court in the past few moments. Gary Glitter, Paul Francis Gad is his real name. He's almost 71 years old now. He was inside that prison van. We perhaps can see a picture taken as he was being driven away from court. He is on his way to prison right now. It was fascinating to see the change in his demeanour today. He arrived for court very, very confident. He strode into court. I watched as he entered the dock. He gave a flamboyant bow to the two lip-speaking interpreters who've been helping him hear and understand what has been going on in court. He is profoundly deaf. He gave a very flamboyant bow towards them and he sat later on, a couple of hours later, as the jury came back in. Guilty verdict after guilty verdict came back and he shook his head from side to side. He muttered under his breath and as he was led down to the cells, his bail having been revoked now and withdrawn, so effectively he is in police and prison custody tonight. As he was led down, he did this kind of gesture towards the court and he blew a kiss to the press benches, and with that he was gone, straight into custody, straight into the back of that prison van. Gary Glitter will be back before Southwark Crown Court on February 27th. He faces life in prison, and at 71 years of age now, he faces the very real possibility of dying behind bars.
And thanks very much.